related aspects. I do book reviews on this genre. So, in the previous session, we were discussing on a book called How to Read a Book by Mortimer J. Adler. See, Mortimer J. Adler's How to Read a Book breaks down the reading process into four distinct levels. So each requiring a different approach and offering varying degrees of depth. So before that, four levels of reading, I have three main key takeaways from the book. So the author says, always inspect the books before you read them. The next thing is, analyze a book's main theme and the author's intention to get the big picture. And the third thing is, question every book's importance and logic. So, how to master the four levels of reading? First level of reading is elementary reading. That means have enough literacy to make out what the text says. Inspectional reading, that means get the gist of a book to decide whether to read it in detail or not. The third level of reading is analytical reading. So, analytical reading is reading a book thoroughly to fully understand it. The next level is syntopical reading. So, syntopical reading is to compare and analyze many books to learn a complex topic. So, we'll start with the level 1 reading. So, this is the most basic level, where the focus is on decoding the literal meaning of the words and sentences. So, elementary reading is about understanding the surface level of the text without any deeper analysis. That means, imagine reading a children's book, a book, which is for a children. You follow the story. You understand the character's actions and you grasp the basic plot without delving into symbolism or the author's message. So the basic things, this is the basic level to understand the character's actions, to grasp the basic plot. The second level is inspectional reading. So this level involves getting a general overview of the book's context. That means you skim through the chapters, introductions, conclusions, and potentially the index to grasp the main ideas and the author's overall argument. So inspectional readings allows us to look at the author's, blueprint and evaluate the merits of a deeper reading experience. So here also there are two subtypes of inspectional reading. So one is called systematic skimming. So this is meant to be a quick check of the book. Suppose in skimming, what we do is reading the preface and studying the table of contents, checking the index, reading the inside, jacket of the book, like reading, just overviewing the entire book. So this should give you sufficient knowledge to understand the chapters in the book. So that is pivotal, that is important to the author's argument. Whatever the author's subject is here, you will have sufficient knowledge to understand the chapters in the book. Dip in here and there, but never with more than a paragraph or two. So skimming helps you reach a decision point. So what is the decision point? Does this book deserve more of my time and attention? If yes, you continue reading. If not, you put it down. So skimming helps you to decide whether you want to read the this book or not. Next is superficial reading. So next subtype in the inspectional reading is superficial reading. So superficial reading is this is when you just read. That means don't ponder the argument. You do not analyze the argument. Don't look things up. Don't write in the margins. So here what you do, if you don't understand something, you just move on. That means just reading. What you gain from this quick read will help you later when you go back and put more effort into reading. So you now come to another decision point. So now that you have a better understanding of the book's contents and its structure, do you want to understand it? Do you want to understand, more of the book? If you want to delve deeper or not? So inspectional reading gives you the gist of things. That means, for example, think of reading a news article. You scan the headlines, skim the first few paragraphs and get a general sense of the story without necessarily reading every detail. So this is inspectional reading example. The third level is analytical reading. So in analytical reading, this is where the active engagement begins. So what you do is you dissect the author's arguments, you identify evidence used to support them, and you analyze the logic behind their claims. So you also consider alternative perspectives and potential biases. So for example of analytical reading is analyzing a history book. Suppose you have to analyze a history book. So it would involve understanding the author's interpretation of events. So evaluating the historical sources cited, you have to evaluate, are the sources genuine or not? And questioning their perspective. So did they consider opposing viewpoints as well? So did they consider the critics as well? So all this comes under analytical reading. The next level is level 4, that is syntopical reading. So this is the most advanced level. That means requiring you to compare the contrast ideas from multiple books on the same topic. What you do is you actively synthesize this knowledge to form your own unique understanding, drawing connections and identifying areas of agreement or disagreement between the authors. So for example, you imagine you are reading multiple biographies about a historical figure. One historical figure, you are reading multiple biographies written by multiple people, authors. Through syntopical reading, you would compare the portrayals, you would analyze the evidence presented in the book, in each book, then you will form your own informed conclusion about the figure's life and legacy. So here what you do in syntopical, you are comparing the different books of the same subject. So here important points, some points to remember are the levels, we discussed here are not a rigid hierarchy. So you might use a combination of levels depending on the type of the book and your purpose for, reading. So in here also, beyond the four levels of reading, the author proposes a three-stage process to efficiently navigate these levels and achieve a deeper understanding of any text. So the first reading, stage one is the first reading. That means after the four levels of reading, this is a three-stage process explained by the author. So the first stage focuses on grasping the fundamental ideas and arguments presented by the author. So this is about getting a clear picture of the overall structure and the main points of the book. So don't worry about memorizing details or critiquing the author's work at this stage. So for example, imagine reading a classic philosophical text like Plato's Republic. So during the first reading, you would concentrate on understanding Plato's concept of an ideal society. So the different classes within it and the role of justice. So where do you apply this stage one? So this stage is crucial for building a foundational understanding. So this allows you to get oriented before diving into deeper analysis. So the second reading here you shift into a more analytical mode. That means you reread sections you found challenging, you take notes, you actively question the author's claims. So consider the evidence they use, the logic behind their arguments, and alternative viewpoints that may not have been addressed. So you basically in the stage two, you are getting into a more analytical mode. You are taking notes, you are marking, margins, and you are actively questioning the author's claims. You are considering the evidence, logic behind the arguments, alternative viewpoints, everything. So, for example here, returning to the same book, Republic, example, during the second reading, you might revisit sections on the philosopher King and analyze Plato's reasoning for this type of leader. So you also do analysis on, are there potential drawbacks? Are there any potential drawbacks? Are there alternative models of government presented in the text? So application. So this stage equips you to think critically about the ideas presented and develop your own informed perspective. The second stage, helps you to think critically and, form your own perspective about the book. Next stage is the third reading. So this stage, stage three, transcends the specific book and encourages you to engage in a dialogue with the ideas. So here you consult external sources like commentaries, historical context, or works by other authors on the same topic. So you might also discuss the book with others to gain fresh perspectives. So ultimately, you aim to synthesize your understanding and form your own unique interpretation. So the third stage is encouraging you to engage in a dialogue with others, to go to external resources. So for example, let's say you have completed the first two stages with the Republic. In the third stage, you might consult a secondary source on ancient Greek political philosophy, explore critiques of Plato's ideas, and discuss the book with a philosophy club. So through this process, you would form your own informed opinion on the text's relevance in the modern world. So the application. So this stage allows you to connect the book's ideas to a broader context. So you integrate them with your existing knowledge and create a richer understanding of the subject matter. So by following, these three stages, you can move beyond basic comprehension and engage with the text on a deeper level. So this will foster critical thinking, intellectual growth, and a more meaningful reading experience. also this was about, you know, how to read a book. So if you have any queries, concerns, thoughts, put in the comment section and stay tuned for more such informational videos. So thank you and namaste.